Take two.
All right, this video is to show how to upgrade the firmware in a Mica Guard. First thing is we open up the Mica Guard and we put a jumper on J8. Then the next thing is on your computer, we need to make sure we've got a driver loaded for the USB. So you go to Pinnacle Systems, Support, and then go to Software Updates. And then down here, we've got Scilabs driver, terminal program, and a PDF showing how to do it. So you download those, put those on your desktop, those files on your desktop. You would install the Scilabs driver. Now, you take a USB cable, plug it into your computer, plug it into the Mica Guard. The Mica Guard does not need to be on, and you wait for that light to turn on. If that light's not on, then the driver's not communicating. You may need to unplug it and plug it in again to try to get it to connect. Then you want to see what COM port it assigned. So the next thing you do is we go to Control Panel, and we go to Device Manager, and we look down for COM ports. We look down at the bottom, we look for a Scilabs or Silicone Labs CP210. It's COM1. You can go in and change it, but COM1 is fine. Close all that. We just need to remember it's COM1. Then we run the terminal program that we downloaded. You don't need to install it, just run it. So when this opens, make sure you set it to custom 230400 8N1 XON X off. Set the COM port to COM1. You have a list of COMs, but set it to COM1. Now we hit connect, the connect button, and we click down into the gray area here, the dark gray box down there. All right, so now with the light on our Mica Guard, we turn on the power, and you'll get a menu display here. If you don't see that menu right away, hit the space bar as soon as you power up the Mica Guard. You need to see that menu. So we get lowercase a, b, and c. So we're going to type a lowercase a, wait for the menu to redisplay, lowercase b. Now we go to send file. We navigate to where we put the firmware that we downloaded. In this case, it's the desktop. We put it in a folder called Mica Guard firmware. So we open that up and we look for the one that's got an S in the name, because that's the slave. So we're going to then hit open, and you'll see asterisks fill the screen, which is good. That's downloading the software into the slave. We wait till it gets a menu redisplay. There we go. So the slave is done. Now we click back down into the dark gray box and we hit C, lowercase c. Now we're doing the master. Now we hit lowercase d, wait for the redisplay. We hit E to program. We go back to send file. This time we're already in the folder. We just hit master. Okay. And wait. And if you see the menu redisplay at any time while these asterisks are going, then you have to start over. Something went wrong. It should be just nice line after line. You can see the master is a little longer than the slave. And we're done. Just so you know, if the communication, if you unplug this USB cable, you'll lose the COM port. COM1 will disappear, it won't be there anymore, and you'll have to hit disconnect and then reconnect when you plug in the USB cable. That's the downside of this USB configuration, is that the COM port disappears if the cable's unplugged. But that's it. You close that, and then you go back, remove that jumper, remove that USB cable, and turn power off, and you're done. That's it.